Hello everyone, this is Munam from Make Web Better and we are back with another exclusive demo video on WooCommerce Abandoned Cart Recovery Plugins Premium Features. So in the part 1 of the demo video, I have explained you about the free features of the plugin and how to create an email workflow. So if you haven't watched the part 1 of the video, so we have mentioned the link in the description content, so you can watch it from there. So before starting the demo video, let me show you how to install and activate the plugin. So once you have purchased the plugin, so you have to go to your plugins menu and you have to click on add new. Then you have to click on upload plugin. Then you have to choose the zip file that you have got and you have to click on install now. So as you can see that the plugin has been installed. Now you have to click on activate plugin. So as you can see that the plugin has been installed. So before proceeding towards the backend settings of the plugin, let's understand what are the premium features which are included in this plugin. So now let's click on settings. So we are on the backend settings of WooCommerce Abandoned Cart Recovery plugin. So in the free version demo video, I have explained you about the general settings, email workflow, abandoned cart reports and abandoned cart analytics, and also the overview section. So firstly, I'm going to explain you about the license tab. So in this license tab, once you have purchased the plugin, so you have to enter the purchase code in order to use the features of this plugin. So make sure to enter the purchase code and click on validate to use the features of this plugin. So this was all about the license tab. Now let's again go back to general settings. So firstly, you have to enable this plugin to start the functionality. So if you have not enabled this plugin functionality, so abandoned cart functionality will not work on your WordPress website. So in the free version demo video, I have explained these features like add to cart pop-up, add to cart pop-up title, add to cart pop-up text and some other features. So if you want to watch the features explanation in detail, so you can check out the part 1 of the demo video. So we have mentioned the link in the description content, so you can watch the part 1 from there. So now let's start with the premium features that will help the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to recover the abandoned carts more easily. So the first functionality is enable to receive abandoned mails. So as soon as the admin clicks on this, so it will let the admin or the WooCommerce merchant receive email notification when any cart is abandoned. So what does this mean? This means whenever any cart is abandoned, then admin will get an email notification in which abandoned price will be written and the information regarding from where the user left will also be shown in this mail. So if the admin wants to enable this functionality, so he can enable it from here. Next feature is enter the title to show on exit intent pop-up. So what does this mean? This means with this premium feature, it will help the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to stop the customers from abandoning the checkout process. Like if I have written enter title to show, like if I have written the title as please some items are left, so this title will be shown as an exit intent pop-up. Next is block IP. So what does this feature do? This premium feature will help the ad. So with this feature of block IP, the admin or the WooCommerce merchants can block the spammers so that the cart abandonment can be prevented. So the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can enter the IPs in this text box and it will block tracking that abandoned cart, hence limiting the spammers and bots. So here the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can enter the IPs and as soon as the IP is entered, so the tracking of that IPs will be blocked, hence it will reduce the cart abandonment. Next field is enable to show content on exit intent. So if the admin or the WooCommerce merchant want to show the content on exit intent, so he can enable this functionality from here and the title that we have chose will start appearing on the exit intent pop-up as title. Next field is enable to show email box on exit intent pop-up. So if the admin or the WooCommerce merchant want to show an email box, So on the exit intent pop-up, so the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can enable this functionality from here, and the email box on exit intent pop-up will be enabled. Next field is enter the content to show on exit content. So if the admin or the WooCommerce merchant want to display some content on exit intent, so he can enter here. Like for example, if I have written So, please buy to get exclusive offers. So this content will be shown on exit intent. So this is how the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can prepare the content or enter the content here to show on exit intent, so that the customers can stop and buy that product and minimize the cart abandonment. Next is enter the disclaimer. So here, if the admin want to enter any disclaimer that is to be sent on email, so here, like for example, if I have written like so, as you can see that I have written the disclaimer as please hurry, coupon is waiting for you. Like if I have written please waiting for you, so this disclaimer will be sent in email. So if you want to track the email, so make sure you have to enter the disclaimer so that the email tracking can be done, so that whether the user has opened the email or not. So make sure to enter the disclaimer if you want to enable the email tracking. So these are some of the features which will definitely help the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to minimize the cart abandonment. So like for example, if the admin or the WooCommerce merchant wants to capture the email of the users, so simply he can enable this functionality, enable to show email box on exit intent pop-up. So this will show up a box where shoppers can enter their email address. So this is how the email will be captured. So these are the some of the features which will help the admin to get the every detail of the user regarding the email, or if the user has opened that particular email that has been sent or not. So once you have done the settings, you have to click on save settings. One thing you have to make sure that the exit intent pop-up will only work if you have disabled the add to cart pop-up. Like if you want to enable this exit intent pop-up, to make sure you have disabled this add to cart pop-up, or vice versa. If add to cart pop-up is enabled, so the exit intent pop-up will not work. So these were some of the features, premium features that were included in this plugin. Now let's see what are some other features in this plugin. So let's click on email workflow. So with this premium version plugin, the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can create unlimited workflows. So in the free version, the admin or the WooCommerce merchant are limited with creating only 3 workflows. But for now, in this premium version plugin, you can add more like this. So as you can see that the workflow has been added, and if you want to add more, you can click on add more. So as you can see that unlimited email workflows can be created, which will help the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to convert your cart abandoners to your customers. So if you want to know how to create an email workflow, so you can watch the part 1 of the demo video, in which I have explained you about how to create an email workflow and how email workflow will work in detail. So you can check out the part 1 by clicking on the link mentioned in the description content. So in this premium plugin, we have added one more field that will enhance the email workflow. So we have added 3 conditions as not opened, 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 and clicked. So these are the 3 fields that the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can select while sending the email workflows after the first workflow is sent. So he can decide the next email workflows by choosing one of the conditions. Suppose for the email workflow 2, like the admin or the WooCommerce merchant selects opened. So this means the second workflow will be sent if the first email workflow is opened. Otherwise, if the first email workflow is not opened, then the second email workflow will not be sent. Same if he selects like opened and clicked. So If the customer or the user opens the mail and clicked it, then the second workflow will be sent. So this is how you can decide the workflow strategy by deciding the conditions for not opened, opened, and opened and clicked. So this was all about the condition field that was added in this plugin in this email workflow tab. Now for email tracking, a site logo and disclaimer is mandatory. So I have told you how to add disclaimer. Now let me show you how to add site logo. So for site logo, let's go to appearances and click on customize. Then you have to click on site identity. Then from here you have to choose logo, like from here you can select logo and you can select, and so the logo is added and you have to click on publish. So let's go again, go back to the, so this is how you can add disclaimer and site logo to start the email tracking. So now let's move to next tab, that is logs. So we are on the logs tab. So this premium feature is very unique, as it will allow the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to keep a track of the mails along with their status. So as you can see that there are three sections: email, workflow ID, mail status. So in this email, so the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can see the customer's email to whom email is sent via workflow. So the email that is sent via workflow will be captured here, as you can see that. And here the workflow ID will be written. Suppose for this email, as you can see that the workflow ID has been 2. So that means the email workflow second has been sent. And for this email, email workflow ID has been sent 1. The mail status, as you can see that, not found. So mail status is coming not found because if you will not enter the disclaimer and the site logo, so the mail status cannot be confirmed. So if you want to track the mail status, so make sure the admin or the WooCommerce merchant has set the disclaimer or entered the disclaimer and added the site logo to start the mail tracking. So this is how the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can keep a track of every email sent via workflow and can see the mail status, whether the email has been clicked or not, or it has been opened or not, along with the email details of the customer sent via workflow. So this was all about the logs tab. Now let's click on abandoned cart analytics. So we are on the abandoned cart analytics tab. So this tab helps the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to show the analytics of abandoned carts, which will help the admin or the WooCommerce merchants to make decisions and to make strategies related to abandoned cart recovery. So as you can see that here are the complete abandoned cart analytics, like how many abandoned carts are this month and how many abandoned carts are till now and how many recovered carts are there for this month, and how much money that can be recovered. So this is how you can easily see the analytics along with the graph of abandoned cart. So in the previous demo video, that is part 1, I have explained you about the abandoned cart analytics in detail. So you can check out the part 1 to know these features in detail. So now let's move to next tab, that is abandoned cart reports. So we are on the abandoned cart reports tab. So here the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can see the reports cart wise and the product wise. As you can see, this is the reports cart wise, and if you want to see the reports product wise, so you can click on this and it will show you the abandoned cart reports product wise. As you can see that reports as per abandoned products, this is the product name, and as you can see that how much time that product has been abandoned. So as you can see that beanie, suppose it has been abandoned 10 times, so the product which has been abandoned the most will be on top, and the product that has been abandoned the least will be on bottom. So let's click on cart. So along with the reports, the admin can also see the or keep a track of the coupon code status, like it is used or sent or not sent. So with this premium plugin, so the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can track the coupon code status, like the coupon status has been the coupon has been used or not, or it has been sent or not. As you can see that the coupon code is here and the coupon code status is showing null. So this is how the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can easily keep a track of coupon code status. So this was all about the abandoned cart reports. So you must have observed that the premium features like block IP, exit intent pop-up, show email box on exit intent pop-up. So these features will definitely help the admin to capture the user data and prevent them from abandoning the carts. And moreover, the abandoned cart analytics and abandoned cart reports will definitely help the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to keep a track of each activity related to email workflow, coupon code tracking, how many emails recovered by the plugin, abandoned cart products data. And this will definitely help the admin or the WooCommerce merchant to plan out the strategies to recover the abandoned carts. So there is one more premium features of this plugin. So this plugin is compatible with various contact form, with various forms like contact forms, gravity forms and ninja forms. So this will definitely help to customize the forms and email content. So all the backend settings have been done for the WooCommerce abandoned cart recovery plugin. Now let's move to shop page and see how these settings will reflect on the front end. So we are on the shop page and let's click on any of the products. So let's click to add to cart. So as you can see that the pop-up, the exit entered pop-up has come. As you can see that the title that we have decided, please some items are left, is coming here. And as we have decided the content of the exit entered pop-up, as you can see that please buy to get exclusive offers. And you can also see that we have, as we have enabled the email, so that email box is coming here so that the user can enter the email here. And the user can enter the email here and click on subscribe us. So this is how easily the exit intent pop-up works, so that the user can enter the email ID, so that the admin or the WooCommerce merchant can easily capture the email address and prevent them from abandoning the cart. So this was all about the demo video of WooCommerce abandoned cart recovery plugin premium features. So if you have any queries regarding the plugin functionality, you can mention your queries in the comment section and we will be glad to help you. And if you are new to our channel, make sure to subscribe the channel and like and share the video. So till the next video, stay connected with us. Thank you.